Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. Okay, we will continue with simple linear regression model. This is section 5.2. Okay, in this particular chapter, we are going to look at how to write a mathematical or how to express a mathematical equation that relate dependent and independent variables. Yeah. Number two, to draw a linear regression line, that is line of best fit. Number three, interpret values of intercept and slope. Yeah. And number four, to use the equation of regression line to estimate values. Okay. So before I go any further, okay, for this, in this particular chapter, actually, there are two types of regression. One is that we are going to look at. One is simple linear regression. Yeah. Another one is multiple linear. Okay. So simple linear, it is simply like the slope of intercept line, y equal to beta naught. Okay. Okay. If this is the estimated, equal to plus beta 1 x. Yeah. So this is simple linear regression. So you can see that beta naught and beta 1 are the parameters. Yeah, this is the estimated parameters. So this is considered as the regression coefficient. Coefficient, yeah. Okay, so this is just the intercept. Yeah? Beta naught is the intercept. Like if you can compare this with y equal to mx plus c. Yeah? So the concept is the same. Instead of m, we have beta 1. And instead of c, we have beta naught. Yeah? You have learned this before, yeah? In algebra and so on. Okay, for multiple regression, the estimated model is y hat equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus up to maybe beta k xk. Yeah, so again, beta naught, yeah, beta 1, beta 2 and beta k are called parameters. Yeah, so what's the difference between simple linear and multiple linear? Okay, simple mean you only have one x. Yeah, simple mean one x. Multiple means you have many x, yeah, many variables, many independent variables. So simple mean one independent variable, yeah, versus one dependent variable. Okay, variable. For multiple, you have many independent variable. Yeah, which variable of power 1 or of degree 1, yeah? 1, yeah? The highest power is x1, x sub 1 to the power of 1, x sub 2 to the power of 2, yeah? So you can see that it is x1, x2 up to xk. Okay? So we have many, yeah? Many independent variables, yeah? Of power 1. So that is why it is called multiple mean many independent variables. Yeah, linear because the power of the variable is 1. Yeah, so that's a different. Okay, but you will we will cover multiple linear regression in chapter 5.5 and 5.6. Okay, so for simple linear we will cover in 5.2, 5.3, and 5.4. Okay. Okay, next, simple linear regression model. Okay, so regression is a statistical measure that attempts to determine the strength of relationship between dependent and independent variables. And regression method describes how one variable depends on another. Okay, so simple mean a model with a single independent variable that has a relationship with a response variable y. So it can be represented by equation of a straight line or known as line of best fit. Yeah. Okay, if you have more than one independent variable, then it become multiple. Okay, this is what I just explained just now. Okay, which we'll cover in 5.5. Okay, next. So this is the model, yeah, of simple linear regression model where we have y equal to beta naught plus beta 1x plus epsilon. Yeah, so epsilon is the random error component. Okay. Okay, using least squares method, okay, I'm not going to go in details, yeah, but you can check this method, how we how the equation become like this, or they become the estimated using least squares method. You can check in the module. We present it in detail, yeah. So the least square method is used to estimate the parameters, okay. We use this method to estimate the parameters. So the estimated fitted equation or line of best fit of the simple linear regression is given by this. Okay. So whenever we estimate, yeah, estimated, so all has hat. Yeah, except x. So y hat, beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat because it is being estimated. Okay, what do we mean by line of best fit? That means we have, let's say we have a data. Okay, we have a data. Yeah, for example. And when we draw line of best fit, yeah, so this is the line that we refer to. Okay, beta naught x. So this is what we call line of best fit, yeah, the estimated line, yeah, or the model, the mathematical model that can represent this trend of data. Okay, so that is what we mean by line of best fit, yeah, mathematical model that can be represented by the mathematics, yeah, that can be represented by the data that we the data that we can present by using mathematical expression. Okay, so this is y hat denoted for estimated dependent or response variable, x independent, yeah, beta naught hat is the estimate of y intercept, okay, the point which line intersect the y axis, that means this point here, beta naught, yeah, this is point here. Okay, so beta 1 is the slope, yeah, the slope, or it is considered as the regression coefficient, yeah, it is called regression coefficient, yeah. Sometimes in the question, yeah, in quiz, we always ask what is regression coefficient, so you should know that this is beta 1 hat. Okay. Okay, this is how we determine or how we calculate the coefficient, yeah, the regression coefficient or the slope. Yeah, so you have seen this formula before, this summation, SXX, SXY, yeah, so you have seen this formula before when we talk about correlation coefficient. Okay, so you have seen this before. Okay, and beta naught can be calculated using y bar minus beta 1 hat x bar. So that is why for this, to find this equation, we always find beta 1 first. Yeah, of course, we calculate the value for SXX, SXY, and divide, we get the beta 1. And then from beta 1, we can get the value of beta naught. Yeah, so x bar and y bar is simply the average of x, average of the dependent and independent variable, yeah? Independent and dependent variable. Okay, so that is the equation. Okay, these are the properties